Let's take a look.
The infection has spread rapidly throughout the prison population. The speed of transmission is breathtaking. Once the first cases emerged among them, the prisoners began to riot. The guards are trying to keep order, but the chaos is spreading. One of the prisoners is helping me with my research. His name is Kevin, and he's been extremely useful as I've been trying to find some sort of temporary drug treatment to slow the effects of this devastating disease. Tetracycline seems to stall the infection, but for how long, I don't know. We've barricaded ourselves in a laboratory as I await evacuation. I'm in contact with my husband, who assures me that a rescue helicopter is on its way.
Dr. White, gather your things. We're not safe here. We need to move.
What I like to see.
all see. And for the love of God, if you come into contact with the prisoners, don't bloody trust them. I'm responsible for a lot of them being here. So they'll kill me, and then you.
What took you so long, Colonel? What kept you?
Who are they?
Who?
I tell you not to play games with me, mate. They're coming here. You were talking to them. Why were you pretending to be me?
Relax, White. I can't tell them who I really am. You think they'd believe a convict? You wanted me to help your wife, right? That's what I'm doing.
I know you, Karen. You're smart, but this time you outsmarted even yourself. I could have given Emily over to the experts.
And what would they have done? They wouldn't even know where to look. Who told you about the virus and gave Emily the medicine to slow it down? I betrayed the consortium for you.
And I betrayed my country. So I would say we're even, mate. But you wasted my Emily's time with your tricks. You've sentenced her to death. Now I'm sentencing you.
They're bringing you the antidote.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm not lying. Your wife still has a chance, Colonel. We made it based on the virus of the natives. I can explain.
I want to hear it from them. You connect me.
No. If they find out I'm not who I say I was, they won't believe anything. You do this, and you risk everything.
Karen, I'll kill you if you're lying.
I'll get the antidote into your hands, just like I promised. But you have to trust me.
Well, let's just see what we got.
Get the knockout gas from Block C and put it on top of the elevator they'll be riding in. We need to get that antidote away from them as quickly as possible, and I'd like to avoid any last-minute negotiations.
Now this is crazy!
Thank you. to prepare that unpleasant surprise for our guests. Place the knockout gas on top of the elevator, they'll be riding it.
Get in, quick!
Now watch.
Are you inside?
Done. Now we go get the cure.
You're not going anywhere, Karen. Move away from the computer. Up against the wall!
White, what are you doing?
I'm saving Emily, and I don't want any more surprises. And if the cure doesn't work, I'll come back here and I'll kill you.
The cure won't help her now. It's a vaccine. It works only up until the first stage.
She is in the first stage!
I'm afraid not, Colonel. Not anymore.
What?
You should have killed me when you had the chance.
That's it then.
Emily, I'm coming. God damn it! Get out of my way!
There.
Just give it up!
Emily, I have a vaccine. Soon... Emily. What if they could create an antidote with this? We can't give up. Hold on, Em. We're going up to the roof.
We gotta move. Come on. There's a chopper on the roof. It's waiting for White.
Kevin told us the plan. You're gonna kill everyone.
He's flying the fuck out of here and calling in the bombers. Thermonuclear annihilation.
Maybe I should start with you.
My name is Ryder White. I'm a colonel with the BIDF.
I saw him and took my wife.
You need to get out of there, and I can help you.
I have it, just as you asked for it.
A super virus derived from a mummy.
Not from a mummy, from her.
It is home to many dangerous criminals and terrorists, including Karen, the infamous hacker for hire who has worked for everyone from Al-Qaeda to the Yakuza. Meanwhile...
As long as the world is the way it used to be.
It's not, and never will be. Trust me.
The source of the plague. A walking time bomb.
Things that go bump in the night. Me, Sam B.
Shrunken head, broken legs, body parts on the concrete. Cut them up, butcher style, gators in the swamp. Red light, leave them dead, running like a track meet. Scared of nobody, what your motherfuckers want? Believe me when I tell them I'm a boogeyman beast. Leave them slashed from their head to their feet. Pin bricks to the chest of a bitch whale. Fan cooking meat, cannibal trying to eat. I got a zombie army, and you can't harm me. Yeah, who do you voodoo, bitch? Drink blood like a vampire without warning. Who do you voodoo, bitch? Stand up. Sam B got the thing that go bump in the night. Whoa. Who do you voodoo, bitch? Hide your kids, grab your wife, better get out of sight. Who do you bitch.
Let's go.
Sam be the Papa Shango, I'm bearing some Eddie. Handful of fingertips, toss them up like confetti. Stable of corpse bitches, I'm a pimp of the dead. Come fuck with a zombie, I put a stake in your head. Look, you want ghouls, I got fucking platoon. Maybe everybody dies, I'll see your ass real soon. Crack bones to the marrow, hot sauce and they suck it. Now my juju ain't nothing to fuck with.
Sam,
I got a zombie army and you can't harm me.
Yeah, who do you voodoo, bitch?
Drink blood like a vampire without warning.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Stand up.
Sam B got the thing that go bump in the night.
Whoa.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Hide your kids, grab your wife, better get out of sight.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Let's go.
Cut your head off, you leave your motherfuckers dead.
I got a zombie army, Sam, and you can't harm me.